Weather in general, wind in particular, has a significant impact on the aircraft operations. Before we understand the impact of the wind on an aircraft in flight, we should understand the three wind conditions. If the direction of the aircraft movement and the direction of the wind are opposite to each other, the condition is known as headwind because the wind is coming onto the head of the aircraft. If the direction of the aircraft movement and the direction of wind both are same, then the condition is known as tailwind. If the wind direction is perpendicular to the direction of the aircraft movement, then the condition is known as crosswind. Wind in any other direction is interpolated based on these three conditions. Now let's try to understand the impact of the wind on an aircraft in flight. It is always preferred to have tailwind when an aircraft is cruising in air, since the tailwind produces less drag and pushes the aircraft in the direction of flight. Due to this, the aircraft will be able to reach the destination sooner. Let's see how. If you want to understand more about the drag, please watch the video titled Forces Acting on an Aircraft in Flight in the same channel. Speed of the aircraft is measured in terms of indicated airspeed. Indicated airspeed is the ground speed of the aircraft plus or minus the wind speed. If the condition is headwind, then the wind is added to the ground speed to get the indicated airspeed. If the condition is tailwind, then wind is subtracted from the ground speed to get the indicated airspeed. Rearranging this equation to get the ground speed will give us ground speed of the aircraft is equal to indicated airspeed plus or minus the wind speed. If the condition is headwind, then the wind speed is subtracted from the indicated airspeed to get the ground speed. If the condition is tailwind, then the wind speed is added to the indicated airspeed to get the ground speed. Let us consider that our aircraft is in air and is flying from point A to point B. The distance between point A and point B is 1,000 kilometers and the aircraft is traveling with an indicated airspeed of 1,000 kilometers per hour. If there is no wind, the aircraft will take 60 minutes to reach from point A to point B. Let us consider a headwind of 250 kilometers per hour. Now the aircraft has resistance from the wind that results in higher drag. So the effective speed of the aircraft becomes 750 kilometers per hour. As a result, the aircraft takes nearly 80 minutes to cover the same distance. In essence, if there is headwind, the aircraft takes longer time to cover the same distance. Now let us consider a tailwind of 250 kilometers per hour. Now the aircraft has assistance from the wind that is pushing it from behind. This results in lower drag. So the effective speed of the aircraft becomes 1,250 kilometers per hour. As a result, the aircraft takes only 48 minutes to cover the same distance. In essence, if there is tailwind, the aircraft takes shorter time to cover the same distance.